I am Ismael Mourifié. I am professor at University of Toronto in Canada. So I am econometrician. So my research is trying to develop cutting edge econometrics method or statistical tools in order to answer relevant or what I think are relevant policy questions. So usually econometrics has been used to try to quantify uncertainty or probably to try to discriminate amongst or between different competing economic theory. So for example, it might exist one phenomena, and for this particular phenomena, there are a lot of competing economic theory that may explain this one. And then based on the data that we observe, econometrics or statistical tools try to see what are amongst those competing theory, the one which is more compatible with the data that you observe. And this is actually, and as soon as the econometric theory can detect this particular competing theory, it can use that to try to make some prediction or some policy recommendation. So the difficulty that happened is in the past, we do not have a lot of access to data. So we can have very simple economic theory that can never be rejected by the data. And now, so econometrics was kind of simple because the model that they have to test were not very complicated. And over here, we have more and more data. And because we have more and more data, the data tend to reject most of the simple economic model that we have in economic theory. So that was, I think, was very good because that pushed economists to think about richer model. And then the model becomes more and more richer and the data more and more bigger too. So in that situation, econometrics theory start to be very interesting because it can no longer be the previous stuff because before it was like a recipe of different remedies. And depending on the issue that the applied researcher has, he come and he pick up the solution and he try to solve his economic problem. But now it's a little bit more difficult because each of the economic problems are so rich and dense, you cannot easily find the solution within that recipe of different methods. And this is why actually I'm trying to play a role. My goal is basically to develop econometrics tool or statistical tool that fit exactly with the particular empirical research that the economists or the researcher that have in mind. And sometimes a lot of the economics tool, you know, of the econometrics tool or statistical tools does not really use some assumption that is not necessarily based on economic theory, or does not necessarily come from the economic model, right? It was one kind of independently of the economic model that we have. And what I am trying to do is to try to develop statistical tools that are really based on the economic model that we have and try to avoid all the ad hoc assumptions that are not relying on economic assumption. So this is basically the general stream of my research. So I have been working recently in one project that I think was interesting. In Canada, policymakers have been very interested in improving the representation of women in what they call science, technology, engineering, and mathematics fields. And the reason is people cite this underrepresentation of women in that field as one of the main reasons of the gender wage gap. So in order to reduce this gender wage gap, it will be interesting to improve the rate of the representation. And over those last 20 years, the policymaker in Canada has been trying a lot to improve the rate, but the rate did not change that much, unfortunately. And one of the reasons is because they have hard time to understand what are the main cause, because it may exist different reasons. And one of the reasons that economic theory said is basically, for example, the fear of discrimination, and wage discrimination, going to prevent some of the smart young girls to go in STEM. But it might be some stereotype. It might be because their preferences are shaped at a very early age, okay, because of this idea of like, blue job or pink job that we have at the very early age. And all those might be the reason of that. And then I am trying to see, based on the data, amongst all those competing theory, which is more the most significant effect on the decision of the woman, and based on that, to try to see what can be the optimal policy that we may implement to improve this this representation of women in STEM. So I found that very interesting because it put me in the place where I have to talk with policymakers, try to understand their constraint, their financial constraint, what they can do, what they cannot do. I have to discuss also with psychologists, sociologists, every type of group that has been working in that underrepresentation of women. And then from my background of statistician, I have also to develop a method that fit with that. So that putting me like in the interaction among different groups that I found very interesting and exciting. I really believe that economics should not be seen as like a very separate discipline, but to me the good things in economics is like is in the center of different social science, like psychology and different some of the things that I think some of the subfield that I think are very interesting is we have now more in economics, but this is what people call family economics that I found very interesting because I am kind of concerned about all these earnings inequality that we observe in the population in general. And to me, one of the main triggers start from the family choice, because the family, the marriage choice, the family economics, and from the marriage choice also there's the investment that we people put in the kid. And then the earlier childhood education is extremely important in my sense, because it can shape all the skill of the kid at a very early age. And also the parent decision also gonna shape the child environment in the long term going to affect his outcome. So to me, it's very interesting how everything is kind of very causal, starting from the earlier childhood education up to the long term. And to me, in this type of trend, there are many different disciplines that play a role, like psychology, sociology is very important. So how to make friends, you know, the peer effect that has been studied a lot in sociology is very important because that really determines the environment where the kid gonna be. And then we know that the environment has a huge impact also on the later outcome of the kid. So it's something that I found very interesting, and I do think that we need to have a little bit more econometrics and statistical tools for that, because it's kind of a very complex economics model where the it's very hard to disentangle the causal path. Because if you want to know, okay, I invest in my child at 2 or 3 years old, and you really want to have an impact 25 years later, there are many different situations that may happen in the path. And so it's very important to develop statistical methods to be able to trace out what are the main impact of that, of different type of policy at that age.